So when you're doing promo for an album, there are a lot of photo shoots involved, and those are long days, and you definitely get to see every side of people. This is taking us back to photo shoots for my album Speak Now, which was when I was about 20, and it's, I don't know, I can't help but notice how much higher my voice was. I mean, what was that? Maybe like, I don't know, curlier hair. It definitely was really curly back then. It was longer. To be young. Today is a very important day. This is the photo shoot for the new album. This is where we'll get our cover shot from. This is where we'll get all the pictures that spell out what the songs mean. And it's just a very, very important day in this whole process for building Speak Now.
I'm Joseph Anthony Baker, photographer here in Nashville.
Looking slightly back up to the mirror.
Shooting her again. We shot the Fearless cover, and she's called us back to work on this. And we've got a full studio full of sets and things that we're going to go through.
It's going to be a really long day. It's going to be two long days. I got up at 5:45 with a smile on my face and came in for hair and makeup, and we'll be here till late tonight. So there are going to be two very long days. We're doing five setups today, five or more setups tomorrow. So it's a lot, but it's worth it.
How we like to work with Taylor is we just set everything up the day before so that the day of the shoot we can just have fun all day long. Some of the things we're going to be shooting today, we're going to shoot plenty of beauty stuff that can be used for cover and inside packaging and publicity and things like that. But then we've built some really extravagant sets. We've built a railroad track set. We're going to actually have her tied to the railroad tracks. We've got a really beautiful dark sort of forest for a really moody shot. And we're traveling outside later today to do a big open shot outside at one of the big mansions here in Nashville. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
Some people say fashion stylist, some people say wardrobe stylist. I call myself a fashion encourager. A lot of the stuff from this shoot is brought in from New York and LA. Showrooms send us samples. Some of it's archival because with photo shoots you don't necessarily have to have the newest season stuff. A lot of the gowns are vintage.
All right, and so we're just going to work it, different curves, and the strength's going to come from, yeah.
I try to approach each song differently when it comes to my albums. It has to fit within the general theme of the album in order to fit on the album. But as far as representing them in the album booklet visually, I just go straight to the lyrics. You have to make sure that every mood that you want to capture is somewhere in that computer on his camera.
That's awesome.
The fact that all the pictures kind of stem from lyrics that I've written, it's so much fun to get to put pictures to your little storybook that you wrote.
So here we are at The Chapel. It's called The Chapel.
When I write songs, there are some that are just more picturesque than others when they're describing what's going on. And, you know, Speak Now is just such an obvious song to play out in a picture.
The song Speak Now is about the person that you love getting married to someone who is just this bridezilla, tyrant, horrible person that they really shouldn't be marrying.
Good. Back up, that's perfect. Two, three, go.
Liz and everybody on my band are in there as extras. Grant is the groom, Al is the preacher. And Liz's hair is something to speak of.
This is so excellent. I feel like this works for the setup because like it's for the song Speak Now, and I would dare say that anyone whose hair is that on their wedding day
should be interrupted. And that should be stopped. If not by me, by the hair police. There's gotta be some show on TLC that interrupts weddings where the hair looks like that. There's gotta be.
You know, I'm not that nervous. I've been planning for this day since I was 3 and a half. So I've had the colors picked out, what my sleeves are gonna look like, the volume of my hair was selected like at an early age. So I feel like everything's finally coming together.
You know, in every wedding, when they had that moment where it's like, speak now or forever hold your peace, it's like everybody's heart's racing. And every bride and every groom has a person that pops into their head at that moment thinking, I wonder. Like, I wonder if someone's gonna come and sweep me off my feet or something.
You've actually stepped out.
Okay.
You've stepped out here and it's this. It's this, I don't know, you can bring down its own.
Should they be like horrified?
Horrified.
I was gonna go with this.
Oh my God. The horrified looks from everyone in the room line is kind of what we based the picture on. And my band definitely aced the horrified looks part.
2, 3, go.
Bigger smile, Grant. 2, 3.
I've always been really fascinated by that moment and how the drama of it right before the vows is somebody gonna burst through the doors? And today, I am.
2, 3, go.